Hello friends, this video clip is on the subject yarn numeric system for worsted count, the yarn made of wool fiber. In the previous classes already I gave brief information on direct system, indirect system, linear, tex, metric count, English count. Okay, so in this video clip I'm going to share small information on worsted count, woolen count. Okay, see, I'm repeating the basic information on measurement of the fineness of the yarn. In textile industry, the yarn is measured in terms of system. Which system? Fineness system. The yarn is categorized, differentiated, as classified in commercial way or in technical way, in system, in terms of fineness. Okay, the fineness of the yarn, the diameter of the yarn, that is whatever it is, count. Okay, the fineness of the yarn, how much fine the industry can use for specific end use or specific fabric production or specific end consumer product or clothing, garment clothing or household product, upholstery, whatever the textile end product. For that particular, we are keeping in view of the particular end use, the process is defined with the fineness of the yarn. That fineness of the yarn is expressed in two terms, direct system and indirect system. Direct system is expressed, is based on the mass per unit length, and indirect system is based on the length per unit mass. In direct system, length is fixed. In indirect system, mass is fixed. This is already explained in before classes. Okay, just I'm recalling. Now, okay, come to here. Metric count only in previous. Let us first explain now worsted count, woolen count, woolen count. See, what is worsted? Worsted and metric count. What is the difference between worsted and metric count? Metric count, the coarser yarn, that is 6 metric count, 6 nm metric count, 7s, 8s, 10s, 12s, 14s. These are the yarns numbers, metric numbers are used to produce a jacket. Okay? The jackets used for winters or cold area conditions. Okay? Especially, of course, the jackets or rugs or any household products. Many kinds of wools are there, and the wool yarn is required. The fabric made for those end products, for heavy jackets or any household products, of course, whatever end use is there. Heavy fabric means about 400 GSM, 500 GSM, more than that. That requires yarns of 6 metric newton, 7 metric newton, 8 metric newton, 10 metric newton, both warp and weft, and also the picks per inch or ends per inch is also vary, 44, 45 or 40, 54. In that, maybe ends per inch may be a 50 or picks per inch may be a 45 or square construction. Most of the cases, square construction will be there. most of the heavy fabric, heavy wool fabrics are of square construction will be there. In some yarn dyed cases, it may differ. In tweed cloths, tweed woolen fabric, it may differ. It depends upon how the design is required. That depends upon it. Usually, the brushed jacket, Melton wool, like that, is there. Go through that. I will come in that wool fabric classes. Now, just I'm saying is the construction of usually solid dyed wool fabrics or heavy fabrics are square construction of 6x6 or 8x8 or 10x10 supports will be there, or plus or minus in the range will be there. But what is worsted? Worsted on the other part of the woolen industry, the second part of the woolen industry is using the suiting fabrics. Nowadays, not only suitings, even shirts. And shirts are fashionable garments also using wool. Say, in our mind, in most of the people's mind, wool means a coarser fiber. Wool means a coarser fiber is of heavy fiber, and fabric made is also heavy, and it is used for cold season, and it is producing heat. This is a normal idea of the people is having. But wool, in my fiber video clips, I told you merino wool is there, merino wool, and Ireland wool. These are the wools. Merino wool is of very fine quality fiber. Even it can be matched to the silk denier, even matched to the cotton fiber, near to the linen, even linen may be a coarser. Such a come to a very fine fiber can be produced by merino wool, Australian. Okay, those wool fibers can be spun like cotton fiber, like staple polished fiber. Gives very soft and fabric, worsted, and also the blend of polyester viscose is other kind. Viscose instead of polyester, viscose with wool. Wool, viscose and polyester mix. Three: polyester, wool and viscose, or viscose wool or polyester wool. The blend, you can shuffle any kind of. It depends upon the end use. It depends upon the commercialization. Means fixing our price. It depends upon other factors. So the fine wool, Australian wool, it is merino wool, Ireland wool, okay, these are the wool fiber produced from the goat, are made very fine like cotton fiber, like silk, very fine, and spun into yarn and used as a woven fabric for shootings or for shirtings, okay, in maybe yarn dyed or solid dyed or whatever. And also the fabric produced by this merino wool or fine fiber wool are of GSM, maybe grams per square meter, maybe like that normal, like other cotton fabric or polished fabric around 150 GSM or 100 to 150 GSM, 160 GSM, in that range will be there. And also the pants, mixed pants, whatever, totally, see, suitings and fashionable, ceremonial fabrics required. Okay, around normal fabrics, 100 to 150 GSM can be produced. Okay. See, that is worsted wool. Okay, worsted wool are fine. See, the things, metric count, see, I am saying is worsted. count. The outside count, see metric count, in metric count 30,000 meters of yarn weighing 1 kg means 30 kilometers of yarn weighing 1 kg use 1 metric count. But in case of outside count, 560 yards of yarn weigh 1 pound means 1 metric count. I am writing here as this is a count, this is a outside. Okay, how it is 560? I am writing here 1 outside count. Outside count defines 560 yards of yarn weighs 1 pound. Okay, weighs 1 pound, 454 grams. One worsted count of wool, one woolen worsted count is defining as 560 yards of yarn weighs 1 pound. In this case, the length of the spun woolen yarn is of 560 yards and weighing 454 grams or 1 pound. Okay, this 1 pound and 1 pound for 560 yards expressed as 1 posted count. Okay, now I'll go for 10 offset count. Means 10 times of 560 yards of yarn weighs 1 pound. Okay, now I'll go for 50. Offset count equal to 50 times of 560 yards of yarn weighs 1 pound. I'll go for 100 offset count. 100 times of 560 yards of yarn weighs 1 pound. Okay, it's enough. 1 to 100. See, I understand. Now by this we can understand the fineness between 1's worsted count and 100's worsted count. Here in 1 worsted count only 560 yards. 560 yards means in meter 0.9144 meters of yarn weighing 454 grams. This is MKI system. In British system, 560 yards of yarn weighs 1 pound. 1 worsted count. But in this case, 10 into 560 means 5600 yards of yarn weighing 1 pound. Really, it's fine. 50 times of 560 means calculate 516 to 5. How much? 5 to 6, 30, 5 to 25, 5 by 25, 28,000 yards of woolen yarn, spun yarn, weighing 1 pound. It's very, very fine. If we think about 100 posted count, means 100 into 560 yards, 56,000 yards of yarn, woolen spun yarn, weighing only 1 pound. Means how much it is fine? Finer. Okay? Very fine. All are weighing 1 pound, but length is increasing from 1 count to 100 count. Okay, hope you have understood all this. Okay, now usually I have usually for suitings or shirting qualities maybe 42, 50 or 65. In this range only you, it's very fine. Okay, this is the offset count. Can you compare with the metric count? Both are only metric count is very success. Metric count very coarse, it is very fine. Okay, and usually this offset count for fine wools is all over the world is normal. But the same thing I'm giving you, other woolen is there, Yorkshire in New York, in America, in New York, there is woolen Yorkshire is there. This is also a measuring system for fine wool, but in this case, instead of 560 yards, it is 256 yards is there. Okay, instead of 560 yards, can I put here 560? I am putting here 560. Sorry, 256. If I put 256, Yorkshire, woolen, York, woolen, New York count, woolen, Yorkshire quality, New York count. See, where, see, there are all the things, the system are there, the systems are made as per the industrial convenience, as per the industrial convenience. Convenience to ease for the process, both for technical as well as commercial purpose. Whatever the system are implemented in the industries, not only for technical production, but also it is ease to make ease for commercialization. Whatever product is produced in industry, whichever area, that is to be two factors are to be considered. One is not only two, many factors to be taken into consideration. One is production, second one commercialization, third one sourcing, and fourth one facilities. Many factors are to be considered to implement any system in the industries. Only one factor we cannot take into consideration. So, these are all the systems made for DNA-TEX, all things, these are all made not only for the ease of suppliers or ease of producers or ease of sellers, it should be ease for everybody. Okay. See, woolen for, in woolen also count 560 yards being 1 pound, but in case of woolen short hair count, 1 pound being 256 yards. Means this short woolen Yorkshire count near, it is coarser compared to coarser, it is coarser because 1 pound being 256. It is coarser side is there. You can understand. You pause this video and note down. But think you will understand the difference. Okay, like that. One more is there, American woolen run count. In this case, 1 pound, 1600 yards weighs 1 pound in American count. In American woolen run, okay, means 1 pound. 1600 yards of woolen spun yarn weighing 1 pound is very finer than worsted count for 560 yards. It is still finer and it is, I am repeating you, woolen yarn count is defining 1600 yards weighing 1 pound. This is finer than is called Woolen Yorkshire Dewar count, which is defined for 256 yards weighing 1 pound. It is coarser than worsted count. Worsted count. Here see. 256 yards is coarser than 560 yards. 560 yards is coarser than 1600 yards. No confusion. Okay. This is how the measuring system is set up by the textile industries to make is the process of production, the process of supply, the process of sourcing, the process of commercialization. Okay. Now, one more linen count is there that will come in the next video clip. Hope you understood this. The yarns, woolen spun yarns, woolen yarns are using for coarser count, metric counts are used for finer counts, finer fiber, worsted, woolen, Yorkshire count, woolen run, these are the counts are used. Okay. Hope you understood. This is an indirect system. Length per unit mass. Mass is same in all the case, that is 1 pound. The length is varying in count to count, worsted to woolen, New York, or New York to woolen, the difference is there. Hope you understood in this information. Please refer my previous video clip on wool fiber. You can find in detail production and source for the woolen fiber, different kinds. Okay. Hope you understood. Please like this video if you like and share to your friends, those who want such classes, and subscribe. Okay. For the next, even one more option is there. Ring the bell for notification. Okay. You know, everybody now mobile is everybody's hand is there. You know very well. If you want my class, you can do anything. Bye.